I don't want the women to think that I'm receiving any special treatment because I'm an officer. I mean, they'll resent it, and I'll lose their respect completely.
You can't be serious. Surely you realise you'll be in danger.
Yes, yes, I do. But this is our chance to show the women that nobody gets special treatment.
I think Mrs. Morris is right. Technically, she is a prisoner and should be treated as such, but, well, we have to show the women that we can take it as well as dish it out.
Well, I think you're wrong, but I shan't press the point. At least I can make sure you are in a single cell and there is always an officer on duty in the communal areas. I would prefer you not to work, though. I can't have Gaffney and her team locked up for 3 days. Is that a fair compromise?
I suppose so. But I don't want anything to jeopardize my position with the women once I'm back on duty.
I'm afraid the department has taken a very dim view of your contempt of court, regardless of your motives. There is to be a departmental inquiry to decide as to whether you may continue as an officer at Wentworth.
See? What did I tell you?
Hey, Mrs. Morris. Is this for real or are you on your way to a fancy dress party?
No, Bea, I'm in for real, as you put it.
Go on, straight up. What did you do? Put the hard word on Ted Douglas, did you?
I think that's more your line, Chrissy.
Good one, Mrs. M.
What did they get you for then?
Well, let's just forget it, shall we?
Meaning you're not going to tell us?
Meaning it's my business, Chrissy. Same as any new prisoner.
That's right. If you don't want to tell us, that's fair enough by me, but you can't blame us for being surprised.
So, for the next 3 days, I'm just like the rest of you.
One of us, are you? That means you take your chances and fight your own battles and don't go lagging to the screws if something should happen to you, just like us.
Are you off your tucker, Mrs. M? So
I'm afraid I am, Lizzie.
Tastes okay to me.
You and me have had a while to get used to it, Bea.
Well, like I said, the first 5 years...
Ah, the hardest.
Well, devil kidneys and the pheasant are off. So I'll put up with Mrs. O'Regan's revenge.
Yeah, well, look, never mind that now. We've got trouble with Gaffney again. She's drumming up recruits to do Mrs. M over.
Typical.
Well, you'd have been better off in isolation, Mrs. M.
I suppose so, Lizzie. I was offered it, but I
just... You mean you could have set it out nice and cushy away from all of us?
Well, why the hell didn't you? I would have done.
Yeah, we know.
How could I possibly justify being treated any different from the rest of you? I mean, if there's going to be trouble, I have to face it the same way you would.
Oh, but you would have been safe, Mrs. M.
Don't worry, Lizzie. She will be. I want you to pass the word around. Nobody, but nobody, touches Mrs. Morris. And that's an order. Anyone who tries different is going to be bloody sorry.
Known if there was trouble, you'd be behind it.
Oh, that's bloody marvellous.
Yeah,
that is...
Get warm.
Meg, are you all right?
I think so. I could have been worse if it hadn't been for Chrissy.
Meg, I have a word for you. Live along, Meg.
Is there something wrong?
Everything's wrong. You think you've got a friend in B. Smith, but you must know by now you can't trust any of these women. And look how they bashed you.
It had nothing to do with B.
I didn't say it did. It's not safe for you when with the other women if you'd only go to isolation.
Steve, I can't. Look, I'm doing this for principle, and I'm sorry you don't agree with me. Now, you said I was vulnerable, and you're right. If I hadn't have had that single cell, this attack would never have happened on me. Well, from now, I'm not going to let that situation occur again. I'm going to work.
Work? Where?
Well, in the laundry, print shop, workshop, anywhere. There's safety in numbers.
You are being released tomorrow morning. The department still hasn't made a decision as to whether you are continuing as an officer.
I know, and I'm sorry. But I can't tell you anything about the attack on Margot.
Here you are, Meg. Now all you have to do is sign out and forget this whole business.
I doubt that.
Hardly an ideal experience for an officer.
Oh, I don't know.
I was wondering if it shouldn't be compulsory for all officers to spend a few days inside. It would help us understand the women better.
Oh, you don't need any help, Mrs. M. You've always been really good to us.
Thanks, Lizzie.
Well, we'll talk about it in the morning. Come and see me before work.
Am I back on duty again?
Well, Mr. Douglas will be phoning later to give me the department's decision, but yes, you might as well start on your normal shift.
I'll see you later, Mrs. M.
Come on, Lizzie.